With gasoline and diesel prices continuing to be volatile, what do you do when your electricity-thirsty business relies on diesel generators for its power? You may think the only reliable alternative is grid power, but for the Amish-run business, Equipment Remarketing LLC, that was not an option. Located in northeast Indiana, the Amish community has a long tradition of living a simple and self-sufficient lifestyle. For this business, that meant finding a way to power their workshops without relying on grid power.
Grid power is just not something that fits into their lifestyle, so they're allowed to use solar power or generated power to run their business.
These buildings are actually not connected to the grid.
They now use a range of Victron Energy equipment to provide all the off-grid power. Like many businesses around here, the business is owned and majority run by the Amish. Their lifestyle surrounds family, humility, and a separation from the mainstream world. The Amish culture is critical of vanity and pride, so requested I didn't film the faces of the Amish staff. I've honoured that when making this film. They consider things like the telephone and electricity worldly because they are used to connect to the outside world. However, they do realise a requirement for electricity both at home and in a business setting. And as long as it's not connected to the grid, it's accepted.
We buy them and then strip them down, put in pins, mass bearing bushings. There's damage to the body panel or frame, we cut that out, repair it. So there's a lot of welding, plasma cutting and bending of metal here, and painting.
Like a lot of the farms and other businesses in the Amish community, the current model is harnessing power from noisy, polluting, and sometimes unreliable diesel generators. This can create enormous fuel bills over a 12-month period.
Originally, they came to us with a concern that they were spending too much on diesel fuel. It was around $6,000 to $8,000 a month, and it was getting into the point where they need another solution. They've been trying all sorts of things, and Brian sat to sit down with them, had a nice chat, and they came to a solution.
Oh, the next one too.
So right here we have a 49 kilowatt solar panel system. And inside our little shed, we have our Victron system, 60 kilowatts of inverters, chargers, Quattros, 10K kilowatts each, 48 volts, six of them. And we have them set up as three phase. And we have a total of 9 charge controllers in there.
Initially, there was some serious skepticism about using solar in the area. A nearby business had a non-Victron system installed, and unfortunately it didn't meet their energy usage and failed. But Brian, who himself is Amish and a Victron distributor, was able to reassure the business regarding having a Victron energy system installed.
I also offered that the system does not meet your needs and does not work properly, that we would take the system back completely. And that gave the customer an assurance that we are in it for a long haul. And so with that, the client said, sounds like a plan. Right now I'm spending, around $96,000 a year in fuel costs, and I'd be love to have that go away. And this is the only other option I have.
As a result, the business has been able to operate completely independently from the grid, relying extensively on the energy generated by their solar panels. This saves them money on fuel costs and allows the business to operate in line with the values of the Amish community.
So So we're right at about a 12 to 16 months period after the product's been installed. And so today I asked the customer how he likes the system, how it's been performing. He said, I love it, absolutely love it. Most of my fuel cost is going away. If there's overcast days or lots of snowy days, the generator still runs occasionally, but it's on whenever there's not enough sunshine. But he absolutely loves it. There's no longer a need for the customer to go start the generator just so he can walk through his facility in the evening and turn on lights or have the garage operate. So with the system now, it's maintenance free, it's lithium battery, there's no more water in the lead acid batteries, nothing to maintain. He just absolutely loves it.
I noticed a big difference in consistency. The lights don't dim, don't go on and off, like especially with plasma welders, that really drains the lights down. Printers don't have to reset, or you have to worry about your computer, and just a lot more consistent power. And we would have power go out because the generator break down or something would trip it.
Before all quotations done or anything being done, we always ask the customers to install a CT. We pay for the CTs. We put in the CTs on the breaker box on both legs to monitor everything that the customer uses on a daily basis. The CTs record up to a month of data. In doing so, we can properly size accordingly to the max amount they use at a given period of time and how much they use on a daily, weekly, and monthly basis.
Their calculation determined that the site could comfortably be supplied with 6 10 kVA Quattro inverter chargers, and that even catered for any spikes in demand. As the business expands, the distributor and installer SES uses VRM to monitor the company's energy usage, ensuring it can stay ahead of any power needs. Using solar as their main source of power, together with a generator as a backup, has allowed the company to make huge savings in fuel, as well as continuing the Amish beliefs of being off-grid. If you want to take your company off-grid, or you simply don't want to be connected to the grid, take a look at the off-grid page on the victronenergy.com website for more information.